On the outside, you look the same. Smiling and pretending is so much work, but inside, it's a different story. You start to hate yourself. You're so alone. So unbelievably alone.
You came.
You're cold.
If I could be a different person, I promise you, I would.
I disgust myself. I close my eyes and hold my breath for as long as possible.
I do love you, by the way. I mean, as much as I'm capable of loving anyone, which is never enough. I'm sorry.
The next time that somebody tells you, the government wouldn't do that. Oh, yes, they would.
I feel like nothing ever works out, you know, like the whole freaking universe is against me.
So does anybody else peel grapes for their kids? Like, why can't the little fucker just eat it with the skin? Why do I have to go through all this? Look how difficult this is. Can I order like a grape peeler from Amazon or something? Is there a way to
what they do, okay? They act like they love you. They act like they'll be there forever. And then one day they'll pack up all their stuff and move away.
On the outside, you look the same, smiling and pretending is so much work, but inside, it's a different story. You start to hate yourself. You're so alone. So unbelievably alone.
I need it to stop. I need everything to stop.
Alright, y'all, you know, it was a good birthday live, my nigga. I'm finna go fucking kill myself.
I wasn't expecting her to fuck somebody else. So when I got back with her the other day, she dropped the bomb on me. I said, did you have sex with anybody else by the 10 days we wasn't with each other? She said, yeah.
I thought that I was back on track, but I feel lost again. You gotta learn to trust yourself. These people not your friends.
Twist cap to vent. So now I'm standing there holding a hairbrush and a pack of markers looking stupid. How was I supposed to know that when she asked me to pick her up a highlighter with a brush to go with it, she was talking about makeup? That's the last time I'm ever shopping for a woman. Next time I'm gonna give her the money, tell her to buy it herself. Hey, thanks for listening to me. Cheers.
Money.
fucking Eagle Double G. Snoop Dogg.
Tried to do it again, and I was like, are you dumb? Because that just doesn't make sense. Like, it just wasn't getting through to her.
What is your definition of happiness?
A clear horizon.
Does anybody else get a weird feeling when you see your favorite person having a better time with other people than they do with you? Like, I'm glad they're happy, but for some reason it hurts.
I put on Survivor just to watch somebody suffer.
So much love that the whole thing feel like a lie. Ain't nobody fuck.
To work last night, and my trainee walks in and I say, good morning, how'd you sleep? And she goes, fine, and storms off. And I was like, okay. And a couple other people saw too, and they were just like, you know. So then, you know, it's time to get going. I'm like trying to go get the truck ready, and I can't find her anywhere. I finally found her. She was in the supervisor's office telling all the lies. And I was like, hold on a minute here. My supervisor comes and talks to me, and he asks how the night went, and I explained to him, and as soon as I open my mouth, he goes, oh, it all clicked with him. So I explained that, you know, we had some issues with documentation, but it's the first night, so it's okay. However, you know, we took 3 hours on a chart. She was feeling a little overwhelmed, and he was like, okay. And I'm like, okay, what? Turns out, she said that I was being impatient and that I was yelling at her to finish her chart. By me turning around twice in the 3 hours and saying, how's it going? That's me yelling at her, apparently. I couldn't offer her any help because she was refusing all of my help. She wouldn't ask me any questions. She wouldn't nothing. So then we ended up going into the office and all three of us talking together. And I told her, I'm sorry if you felt like I was being impatient. What can I do? How else should I communicate with you you know, you're not asking me for any help. You're not asking me for any assistance. And my supervisor goes, I've known her for years, pointing to me. She is great at her job, and you need to be thankful, and you need to start accepting some constructive criticism, because that's the job. We're here to teach you. We're here to learn. And then he told her, he goes, when I was a trainer, I would just let my trainees fail. And then at the end of the call, when we'd review it, I would come down them and come down on them hard. So you should probably be thankful for your trainer that's right there, because she wants the best for you and she's doing everything she can for you. He knows all this extra effort that I've put out for her. I thought we had sorted things out, and then we get into the shift and it's a complete shit show. Disrespectful, no initiative, not trying to learn, absolutely nothing. And I'm so fed up. I'm like, why am I wasting my time? If you don't want to be here, don't be here. This job takes a heart.